Hello, good day everyone. My name is Jane Andaloza from Grade 12 Heisenberg. And for now, I am going to discuss the philosopher Socrates. I am going to discuss Socrates. Socrates is at once the most exemplary and the strangest of Greek philosophers. He grew up during the golden age of Pericles, Athens, served with different sections as a soldier, but became based known as a questioner of everything and everyone. His style of teaching, immortalized as the Socratic method, involved not conveying knowledge, but rather asking question after clarifying question, until his student arrived at their own understanding. Socrates wrote nothing himself, so all that is known about him is filtered through the writings of a few contemporaries and followers, most notable student Plato. Socrates was accused of corrupting the youth of Athens and sentenced to death. Choosing not to flee, he spent his final days in the company of his friends before drinking the executioner's cup of poisonous hemlock. Socrates was born and lived nearly his entire life in Athens. His father, Sophroniscus, was a stonemason, and his mother, Panarete, was a maidwife. As a youth, he showed an appetite for learning. Plato describes him eagerly acquiring the writings of the leading contemporary philosopher Anaxagoras, and says he was taught rhetoric by Aspasia, the talented mistress of Greek Athenian literature, Pericles. Did you know, although he never outright rejected the standard Athenian view of religion, Socrates believed were non-conformist. He often referred to God rather than gods, and reported being guided by an inner divine voice. Socrates' philosophy can be summed up in his famous statement, "Know thyself." Know thyself, which means that we must understand our own nature, desires, and limitation to lead a good life. His observations for a good life were centered around the examine of life concept. That would be all, guys. Once again, Jenny.